2022 Farnborough Air Show. First time I've been to this show. We thought that it was going to be big before we came down here, and I think we've just scratched the surface today. Spoken to a lot of people about what we're trying to do as a business. It's been interesting, really. I think the aviation sector was one that was really hit hard by the global pandemic. And speaking to some business owners here, you know, there was a lot of people who were touch and go if they were going to go bang, really, because their industry was just decimated overnight. But apart from that, you can see that this is a sector where there's a lot of money, there's a lot of technicality, and there's a lot of R&D going in.
I mean, what we've seen today is everyone who's in it's here. We've met some incredible people, people who I'd never normally get to speak to within the industry sector, people I would never get to speak to if I was trying to make a phone call, which you just wouldn't get through to them.
Great to see some old friends, great to see some old suppliers and new customers. So yeah, it's been fantastic.
Our system, we're hoping to be like the airport equivalent of the drone industry. So we're hoping to operate with lots of different drone platforms and they can use us as a service.
That's a compression spring. Some springs are made entirely from hands, some springs are mandrel coiled, auto coiled. Got some good kit in our place. And then there's all sorts of springs. So we do torsion extension, mainly for aerospace.
The springs we're using in aerospace will predict the life, will predict the relaxation. So before we even pick up a piece of wire, we know exactly how long it's going to last and what's going to happen to it during its life cycle. And that's where we come in, optimising the design to optimise for weight, optimise for force.
We have to upskill in this country. Everybody knows we've got to upskill. Automation will just give you the ability to upskill all the layers. I've had it obviously for 30 years, robots replacing jobs. They don't. They replace tasks, they don't replace jobs. Most places grow when they've got automation. So you just give a more satisfying job, 100%.
The international side is what excites me. I think obviously when you're in recruitment and my previous companies before that in the metal industry, it was all just UK based. Now I've got the opportunity to come to more exhibitions, travel worldwide, see more customers. I think that was a big excitement for me.
If you're going to come to and invest sometimes a lot of money in an event, an exhibition, you really need to plan what you're going to do, who you're looking to engage with, you know, what are the opportunities. So for example, we work with Farnborough International, and all the companies here, UK companies anyway, have a chance to indicate which foreign delegates from which countries they would like to meet.
It's been promising. People who engaged with the Metal magazine, some of the video content we spoke to, and from the recruitment part as well. Obviously a lot of people speaking today where there's a skill shortage, both in operationally and in the technical sales side. So it's been some really promising conversations. Yeah, looking forward to getting back in the office and reporting back to the team about what we've done.
There's a lot of those type of companies that are here that are kind of streamlining. I think, again, in the sectors that we've been dealing with, it's kind of, this is the leading kind of market that's then going to drop down into some of the sectors that we're working with. So definitely Paris next year. Yeah, good show, really good show. And the footfall, considering it's the best part of 40 degrees today, has been frightening. I mean, this is a really, really well attended show. I think as an exhibitor, you definitely think you're getting your money's worth by the amount of people that are going to be turning up.